Hey guys, this is Charlie Blonde back with the second tutorial on this Flourish. I'm gonna also, still on 2.77 and such. So, now we're gonna get into the leaves. The one I was doing, it's on a different layer, never mind. Basically, I have this ball here, so I'm not clicking on something, I don't get those weird, I don't want this origin point ever showing up, so I just click on this. That's why I have that there. All right, so this is what I have. It's a 2D, but it's on different layers per se. I could also move this up, so that way it's not touching with the other one or interfering. But with 2D, it doesn't do it as much. At least I don't see it happening. And you can see that the leaves are pretty much coming to life here. They grow and then they come back in and then stay in place. As well as here, where the end of the vine is far greater than it should be, but then comes back in and gets back into like its normal small shape or whatnot, the original shape, but see, it's like it kind of grows out and comes back in. So let's go over that part of it, since the first tutorial was on how to get the vine to grow. Now you're going to add certain elements to the vine to bring it more into like an actual plant that's growing off into different things. All right, let's begin. So what I was noticing, and let me just duplicate this, send it to a different layer. Let's put it over here. Go over there. So we have this little piece, and let's just stop it where we don't need. So it starts right here. Oh shit. Back. S. There we go. Let me turn on screencast. You can see that it kind of grows in, and that's great. And it grows where it needs to, and it starts where it needs to with the vine, and then the leaf comes in, growing from nothing into something, and then it comes back in, showing that the leaf has its own movement, its own life. And that's pretty cool. Now this is the problem where I use location, rotation, and scale to pretty much calculate where it's going to be and how it's going to scale up and how it's going to rotate while it's growing on the vine. The problem with that is if you do it that way, say you want to duplicate it. You want to put it here, you want to rotate everything, right? You want to maybe you want to add a little bit here, you want to scale it down. You want to say, you know what? What if I had it going here and then, you know, having it grow over there? Problem with that, it was, and of course you'd want to change the keys of when the vine actually grows. The problem with that is there's no leaf there anymore. Let me put in a cube just so I can click on it. There isn't a leaf anymore. The leaf has now gone back to the actual location, rotation, and scale. See, it's right there. See, I can move it, whatever, but it's always going to be that because I have it locked in. So what I was doing today was trying to figure out how to do it on the shape keys, and you can. It's just a little bit harder. So I think it's a little bit harder or a little more time that you have to put in. But I think it's worth it because then you can move it around. So what I was trying out here was, let's see, was this one it? This one. I think I was just trying out different ones where if I could just change the size and the rotation at the same time. See, right? So right here I was just messing with the scale and rotation and maybe rotation here, but no. So for right now, this one was the best one that I came up with where everything is controlled by the shape keys, and it looks very similar to it, if not a little bit better as well. So I get the same results, and I'm able to now move it around, scale it and such. Only problem is I am doing off the cursor and I shouldn't do that. Medium point, active element, individual origins, sure. No, not individual origins. Active element, there we go. Hopefully that shouldn't mess up anything. Okay, so now it's growing and you get the leaf. So now you're able to, say you wanted to make it, you know, add on to it, like, you know, like you just wanted to create your own flourish. Now you can get individual vines and replicate it, and say you want to add more here, but you want to make it smaller, just keep adding to it. And now you got your own little vines here. Of course, you got to time it out right. So say you want to do this one, you're gonna go back over here, say it's gonna start growing here, get this one is called plane 57. Where are ya? I believe it is here. So it's gonna start on 26. Length of 20, that's fine. So it's gonna go and then start growing out. And then you're gonna have to just retime the leaf. Where are ya? Here, this is plane 56. There we go. So these right here. Wait, let's see when it actually comes in. So it's probably gonna come in right about there. Move. Looks like we're not moving a certain part, the size. The size has been locked, so that's why. Should have paid attention to that. But basically get all these that are in here. I wonder if you can just select from here, but oh well. Move it over, and it should be now where you want it to be. And then that one starts growing, and then you can do it like that. So there you go. And if there is a certain app that offsets things for you automatically, please let me know. That'd be cool. You know, still trying to figure this out. So there's that. So let me now get into the tutorial, and the explanation is now over. So let's get into the very basic of this, where you don't even know how to, let's just say you don't even know how to make the leaf. So you've already done the vine, but you haven't done the leaf, right? So you gotta make the leaf. Just bring that into view. So let's bring in the image that I had. Where are ya? Is that it? No, it's not. This one's it. Of course, there was a bunch of different leaves, a bunch of little different things as well. This was basically a vine that is the same concept. The leaves were a little different. Yeah, different leaves. Basically, all the leaves were pretty much done the same way. So let's hide this one. To make a new one, I'm going to do a plane. Whoa. Did it backwards. Let's go into wireframe mode. I think it's I to invert. That was something. Either way. Delete all that, leave one vertice. I like to just get one vertice, hold down control, and then just start lining it up. And let's go back around, because I want to make it all one, and I don't want to come in and make another hole and such. So let's do that, and then get those two, and F for, you know, face, whatever, put the little line in. Now we get all of them. I think it is Control F, and insert faces, fill, I think it's fill, yeah, Alt F, fill, bam. There you go. Now you got your leaf. thing. You can just give it a color, which I already came up with, which is green. So, you know, you could change it a different green if you'd like. Make it a little darker. Actually, I can't because it would affect everything else. Plus, now it should be a different color. Okay, let's turn this off since we don't need it anymore. Where are ya? Background images. All right. Hopefully that didn't hurt your eyes too much. And so now with the within object mode, we need to do the basic form. So this is the basic form. Actually, let's take it off just in case. And this is the basic form, but let's make it a little bit bigger. Actually, let's move the origin point just at the tip of it. So let's put it right. I want it right here. All right, and then move it back to where it wants. So I want it to end up right here. Okay. And now we do shape keys. So let's add one. Let's add one for the x-axis, add one for the y-axis, add one for size, and add one for rotation. Yeah, I mean, you have to do it all. So that's the hard part, right? Okay, so let's add one for size. X. Y. And rotation. Okay. So from here to here, we just need to make it move. So I'm gonna make sure that everything's going following the right path. So from here, I'm gonna move it over here. And that's where I want it. Now we go back to object mode and we see that it'll move over there. So basically it's gonna start over there. This is where I want it to start. Put it to 100. Insert keyframe. And I should have put it in keyframe right away where it was, because then I wouldn't have to redo it again. But you can easily just put another keyframe in, and yeah, if you make my mistake. Okay. So now we got to work on the Y, and we got to put it all the way up to there, or I'm sure you're gonna have to go back and kind of fix it up little by little. So this is just like the basic of basic right now. So that actually make it a little bit farther, because you can make it as far as you want, because you can just not make it 100%. That's always nice. So right now it should be here. For here, this one, the Y is fine. Let's say I want it here. Actually, let's go back over here because that's where we want it. So let's just put the insert frame. Let's go back to, say, just any kind of frame in there. Put it up to where you want it. Where did my mouse go? There we go. Okay, say where you want it. Insert keyframe, and hopefully it should fix the other ones, but it didn't. So let's put it down a little bit more. So frame by frame. Almost a zero, basically. Yeah, it is zero. Now, the problem with the Y is, well, with the X, we couldn't see if it was keeping up with the vine, so now we have to just fix the x-axis here, put another keyframe for the x-axis, and put another one for the Y, and see if it still lines up everywhere else. Okay, so we got to fix this one as well, a little bit up. Oops. What you could do also is just turn on record, make it a little easier, that way you don't have to keep right-clicking it and putting the frame manually every time. Okay, so now it follows it pretty well. Now we just gotta mess with the size. Actually, let's start with the rotation, because if we do with the size, we're going to start with nothing to something, and that might get a little bit weird. All right. Let's go into edit mode. It's the rotation. Actually, here, click there, Shift S, cursor to selected, medium point, origin, individual origins. I think it would be the same thing as individual origins, right? Rotations. Now it seems to be in the middle. So let's just do the 3D cursor. So I put 3D cursor where I wanted it, and then now I can rotate it to, let's just put it a little bit farther than I want it to rotate, because then you don't have to put it to 100% on here. You can just put it to like 80, and that way you have a little more control where you're actually going to be rotating it and stuff like that. Yeah. Okay, take that off. Now let's go to the end frame. That's we're gonna have the, that's where we want it, so that's what's gonna, you know, it's gonna happen. We don't have to change anything on that. On this one though, see, we don't have to go all the way to 100. We just go to let's see, about 0.65 or so, and that's pretty good for me. And then it starts following it. We can add a, we can change the rotation here. Okay, not too bad. It's gonna go so fast that you really won't notice it. And say that if you really wanted to be perfectionist about it, and you see that it's just a little off on the X, you know, you can go back and change it just a little bit. Replace keyframe, and then it just fixed it. There you go. You know, and stuff like that. Like, you can see that this is just a little bit off, but yeah. Now we're gonna mess with the size, because even though the rotation does kind of mess with the size, you can see how it starts off big, gets small, and then gets bigger again. It's not such a big deal when you as much, because it's going so fast, just a few frames, that you won't even really tell about that. But you can fix it with the size now. So with the size, you go into tab mode, you say size, you put 0, and bam. Did I mess up? Did I do something wrong? No, there we go. I need to go back into object mode. Okay, let's go back that. This is where I want it to be, so I'm going to put a key there. Let's do a 100. Whoa. What are you doing? It should be 0. That's really weird. It's acting like a rotation right now. It's really weird. Let's try it again. Sizer. Yeah, I'll keep it. Sizer. It's fine. Let's see if we can, I wonder if the rotation is messing with it now. That it is messing with the size or something. Tab mode, size, 0. Boom. I was having a lot of issues with the rotation versus size here, so I'm wondering if maybe you have to mess with the size first and then mess with the rotation. So hopefully not. Okay, so we got this down, so now it's going down. Maybe it's the order of operations is going in. Like, maybe size has to go on the bottom or something. Now, we know that there has to be an this is going to be what it's going to be there, so we're going to put a keyframe for that. And then at the this part right here, yeah, it's messing with it. It's weird. Do you have to mess with the rotation then? So say we know that the size is going to be 100% here, or 1, and rotation, maybe we have to mess with the rotation this way, where it's 0 here, I guess so. I guess we have to turn rotation all the way off for this one. Otherwise, the rotation is going to mess with the size. Huh. Okay. So as long as you You have to mess with the rotation and the size, kind of like you're messing with the X and Y. They both help each other, I suppose, but it's learning. And I guess if you put it to zero here for the rotation, it's gonna mess with, is it gonna mess with other things? Turn the size a little down. I guess you could hide it. So say you... Oh, you can't put it any more lower. Never mind. Let's just try and do the best we can. Rotation. I guess mess with the size first and then mess with the rotation. That would be my best bet. Okay. Okay, everything looks okay now. So far. Everything's going good, so I'd suggest just practice that. I'm going to continue to keep practicing this. Now that we have the size down, everything's pretty good. Let's count. I think it was 8 or 12 frames, so 6, 7, 8. Let's do 8 for now. That looks about right. And this is where it's already grown to like the biggest size that the leaf will grow, and then it'll shrink back down to a smaller version or a smaller size or something like that. I think also, and I'll do this a little later that right now for now. Anyways, the size, let's bring it back down to 0.2, something like that. So now it's big, and then it kind of shrinks down. So it's still giving it kind of a life, some kind of movement or something. Also, another nice trick is when it's growing, instead of going all the way, you know, like big as it is right now, right off the bat when the vine ends, the leaf ends, we can select the size. Where are ya? Let's select size and rotation if we can. Oh, this one's here. I wonder why. Did it frames? I don't think we needed that. For some reason, there was another keying here. That's weird. I think we could just mess with the size here. Let's just move it like 2 frames. Yeah, we can. Kind of. Kind of messes it with it here, though. So what we could do is just remove it. But that's, you know, perfectionist stuff. That. Rotation, I think. Put it back. And this is what I mean by it. You're going to have to fix it a little bit more because it's shape keys and stuff. I guess they're affecting each other. So it's going, and then... The vine has stopped, but then the leaf is still growing out, and then it comes back in, which is pretty nice. So, since we did move this 2 times, let's move this 2 times and give it that time that we took out. And there we go. Move the cursor, that way we can see better. Oh no, what are you doing? Oh, I was in edit mode, wasn't I? Or something like that. Okay. Now you got that, okay. And now that you've done all that work, right? Now you can Shift D, duplicate it. Take it off the cursor, just do active element, rotate it, and just keep putting them on there, and it should come out okay. And then you can make your own different kind of vines and stuff. Alt A. There you go. Now you can do your own different things. If you make enough elements and stuff, and I'll keep trying to do elements and sharing them with you guys if I can. You know, if I got the time and all that. But hopefully this helped you out. There's other things you can do, like flowers and stuff I've seen online. For this part where I just want to share this part as well. For the part where it is growing and then comes back in, it is a shape key as well, and that's kind of where I thought maybe I could do the same thing with the leaves, and it's a lot harder, but I think it's more rewarding because then you can manipulate it better. So what you do is here it's this, and otherwise it would have just been this, and it would have been in place, and it would have been too static, I think. So with this on, it makes it bigger. So let's see if I can. So right here versus this. So it's not too much of like an effect. It's not the biggest thing in the world, but it does add a little more life to the end. Instead of just being bam, it's done. Gives it that like it's alive kind of feeling, and that's what's really cool about it. Okay. Sorry for making this longer than it should. I just want to explain every little bit of my tutorials, and let me know if this was cool. You know, thumbs up if you liked it. That way I know if I'm doing stuff well. And I'm gonna try and make flowers next. I think that'll be my next thing. All right, this is Charlie Blonde, and thanks for watching.